Hey everyone, welcome back to another video. Sorry we've not been around as much lately, and we got hit by a nasty little bug. Okay.
It feels like we've all been ill for a number of weeks, so we haven't really felt up to filming or editing or doing much really.
No, so that kind of brings us on to a little update. We've got our medicals booked for tomorrow, so obviously I want to kind of concentrate on being a bit well for that really, it's a little bit important.
So the medicals is our hopefully last piece in our PR application. We've done the skills assessment, we've now done our police checks, so whilst we've been absent we've also been doing them. Again, because for UK we already had to have UK police checks to come out on our 482, and we've had to have them again to apply for the PR.
It only lasts a year anyway, so we've done the UK ones and they take a stupid amount of time, whereas the Australian Federal Police ones over here are half the price and take half the time.
And the UK ones, they won't send them by email, you have to wait for paper document, and for us that takes even longer because we've got a redirection on our mail back in the UK. But yeah, the Australian ones were cheaper, quicker, easier, and yeah, so now we've got all of our UK police checks back, all of our Australian police checks back, and yeah, just medicals to go tomorrow. So I think we're gonna do as much filming as we can. We'll give you a little update on what happens. And
well, yeah, because you don't really see many videos on the whole medical process, even though you Google it and it just kind of gives you a rough thing, but you don't really get, I know you can't obviously film in there being a medical centre, but we've got a trip into the city tomorrow early.
One of our lovely subscribers has told us about her encounter with medicals but back in the UK, so she had to have hers before she comes out. So we don't obviously know what it's going to be like this side. Is it going to be the same or different? And yeah, that was the good thing about coming on the 482. We didn't need the medicals. And actually, for the PR visa, we haven't needed to do the English assessment either.
I think that's kind of covered under the whole skills assessment umbrella. But yeah, it was just been a bit of a slog. You had to wait quite a while for these appointments. They're not cheap. I think we've done a video on how much it cost. So yeah, it's been a long, hard slog. Also, another update. I've been here 1 year now.
Happy anniversary. I haven't quite been here a year yet, but that's gone crazily quick.
Well, just to think we've had two houses since we've been here. And it doesn't feel, I'd say probably it feels like 3 months I've been here. Mad how to think, wow, a whole year I've been here.
I know, so when we're feeling a lot better and we've got a bit more time, we're gonna do a little 1 year sort of look back, because I think we'll be surprised and shocked ourselves at how much we've done in the last 12 months. So we thought that would make an interesting video, especially for any new viewers who haven't been following our journey up to this point. So we'll try and get that out soon.
And for our viewers as well, we've got our little promotion going with Seven Seas, and they've been very kind to give us a little discount code to pass on to you guys, so when you can use their services they're offering a 10% off, so that's a big saving, especially in this probably grand or so.
We'll link the code in the video, and you can also find it in the bio Instagram, The Great Emigrate. We need to got members.
So I know we've been a bit quiet, but I know if you want to get your little extra fix of The Great Emigrate and behind the scenes and a few outtakes and stuff like that, we've got a member section.
Yeah, so we have got some content on there already, so we will try and be a bit more active on the YouTube now we're all feeling better. But if you have been missing us and you want to have a little look at some videos that aren't available on the normal YouTube channel, you can subscribe as a member and see them on there. I think we also talked in the last video about a little hiccup at home in terms of our mortgage and things, so we're going to be putting a video on there and specifically about that to let you know what's going on back in the UK. And
a few like tours as well, like tours we've done behind the scenes and stuff like that.
We just wanted to record a little few extras just for anyone that might want more than the normal YouTube. But of course, our normal YouTube is free. You can hit subscribe if you're not already subscribed, and if you enjoy the content, please like the videos. Let us know in the comments what you guys have been up to whilst we've been a little bit absent. I see on the Instagram lots of families making the move now, which is really exciting. The other update that has happened since we've also been sick is that the UK and Australia have come to an agreement, so dog quarantine will reduce back to 10 days from 30 now, which is amazing because...
That was hard work, especially for little pups, and it cost us a fortune in roast chicken.
If you haven't been watching, when we sent our dog to quarantine, she went on hunger strike and we had to DoorDash roast chickens to her. So yeah, 30 days to 10 is great if your dog is also on hunger strike. Luckily, she's back with us, but really good news for anybody that's sending their dog out here. It's such a stress on them to be away from you for that amount of time. And
well, it's stressful for us as well, isn't it? You don't know how they are. They don't really keep you that majorly updated unless there's any big problems. So yeah. I know you don't want to hear from them, but you also email them and ask them for a photo, and they're a bit hesitant to give you a photo.
So we're really happy for anyone sending their dog over. That's amazing news and really good.
So there you go, a little quick update just to let you know we are still here and we're just recovering, but yeah, we'll be back on the video trail again. We've got a few more things. I've had a birthday, so the big birthday was the cutoff at 45, so that was a big one. So we've got some videos coming up about what we did on my birthday and stuff like that. So if you're liking these videos,
please hit the thumbs up, please subscribe if you're not already subscribed, and
see you in the next one.